something that always strikes me as peculiar is the fact that there's so many entities wanting to push those real estate agents, yours truly included, out of the business. And we had a client a while back, motor cop I used to work with at the LAPD, very good guy. We sold their house in Agua Dulce, and he was buying a house to close at the same time in Oklahoma. Well, what does this have to do with real estate agents getting out of the business? I'll tell you this, Oklahoma, they're about three pieces of paper for the entire transaction. State of California, there's 41 disclosures that accompany a real estate contract. Whew. Each one built on a lawsuit at some particular point. Now, while real estate agents are not able to engage in legal representation services, we're not lawyers, we're agents. The fact of the matter still goes through that those real estate agents need to at least have some semblance of understanding, be professionals in nature when it comes to those contracts. So people wanting agents to leave the world of real estate, having people going it on their own, not going to happen. Different than the travel agent world, that whole system. Let's say they try to automate real estate where you have robo-viewings, you have remote showings of residences, you have somebody on a video camera from the other side of the world talking a person through the house on different TVs as they light up, as the sensors in the house relay the buyer's position. They can say, oh yes, how do you like the kitchen? It's got travertine flooring. It's got quartz countertops. As they transition from there to the hallway, well, you know, the hallway is actually 2 foot larger than your typical hallway in the size. It does have arch entry doors. It does have blah, 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 blah. That is great. That is showing real estate. But the writing of the offer, the negotiating, those are things that are going to require a lot of skill. You say, well, anybody can write an offer. Maybe in Oklahoma, anybody can write an offer. And that's just going to get more convoluted, too. I mean, that was three pieces of paper back 10, 12 years ago. And back then, we didn't have as many. Now we have 41 disclosures that all have to be signed. All should be read by the person buying or selling real estate. That doesn't even include the listing contract and all of those other items that are required for the seller to fill out about their residence to be conveyed to the buyer, so the buyer knows everything they could possibly know that the seller remembers or can convey about the condition, about the happenings and goings on within the property that they are selling. Lots. There's a lot to it. So that being the case, I would say now, here to stay. I do think the process is going to be more streamlined potentially, but there is going to come a point where you're about to get lent $500,000 or better to purchase a house. You're going to want a guide. You're going to want somebody in your corner, and you don't want it to be somebody that is a key turner only. You want it to be somebody that has knowledge and experience as far as real estate goes. And you're going to want that person not to be just another blank agent. You want them to be knowledgeable, experienced, and to be willing to put themselves in the way of any harm that may come to you. That's what I think. That's my silly little theory. I will tell you, when I go out and want to buy something, I want to buy a car, I really appreciate an educated salesman. Yeah, there's a lot of those car sites. Oh, you can buy a car with never having talked to anyone. It's not bad, kind of being shown. I bought a car once. I didn't let the salesman walk me through anything. And it wasn't until I turned the car in, I figured out maybe only half the things the car did or was capable of doing. So I kind of look back and say, gee, I really wish I would have. Oh, yeah, you can Google it. Sure, yeah. It's different. You can watch the YouTube video on it. Yeah, that's true. But, you know, hands-on in front of a real human being, that's a whole different animal. And I think there's a lot of value there. And I think even with the new generations that my generation talks about, oh, they don't know how to interact with people and they don't, you know, I think that's hogwash too. I think there are a lot of people out there that, yes, they've been raised in the Nintendo environment and they're kind of latchkey in nature. However, those people, I still think they want to communicate and they want to have that human approach and face-to-face and handshake and look you in the eyes and know that what they're doing or what they're embarking on is going to be something that will be worthwhile in the long run. That's what I think. I'm Connor McIver. I hope you're doing great. Thanks for tuning in. This is kind of what I think about agents going away. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. Be safe.